Wonders shall never end. Pastor shaves the female church members in church right in front of everyone. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're seeing this face for the first time, my name is Octavia Cora. Like, subscribe, share, and join the family. Let us gist, let us dissect. So, today we have a hot topic. Let's get into it. Welcome to Life Experience on my channel. If you love this series, click on the playlist and watch all the videos on that playlist. Okay. All right, so let's get into the hot gist. As Africans will say, wahala deo, yawa dongas. There's this video that is trending. I'm telling you, it's all over Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, everywhere. Okay, let me give you the gist and then we will analyze and dissect it together. And let's share our opinion. What do you think? And what do I think? Let's get into it. All right. So, a pastor was preaching in church and he asked all the female in the church, that's the female church members, to step aside, that to one side, and he asked them to form a line and come out one after the other, and he asked them to take off their undies, and he had a shaving stick on his hands. This is not a joke. This happened in Ghana, in Africa. Okay, if you don't know where Ghana is one of the countries in Africa. All right, that's where this whole crazy stuff happened. I cannot believe this. So, on this video, you will see the ladies coming out one after the other, standing in front of the so-called pastor, this man of God, a man, not a woman, standing in front of him. And he has another man standing beside him with a bowl of water and a tissue paper on his palms. And then this pastor is shaving, you know, like shaving, and the man has the tissue paper underneath, and the girls is holding her clothes up so the man can shave the hairs from her private part, and he's dropping on the paper, and the other one is holding, the man is holding the bowl on his left arm, and his right hand is under her hoocha hoocha, you know, down there, and he's receiving all the hairs. And he's talking, he's not even concentrating, no. He's doing it very aggressively, in my opinion, because you see one of the girls, she checks, you know, like, I don't know, but if you watch the video, you will see, don't worry, don't even think that I'm making up stories. Watch this video till the end, because I will insert the clip at the end. You will watch it yourself, and you will see for yourself what I'm talking about. This is not a joke. I'm not trying to make up stories here. Okay, this is real. And he finished with the first girl. She left, and the second one came out, took off her panties in front of him, and pulled her gown up, and he's there shaving the second one. And that's how they were, he was taking turns, and you know, the girls were taking turns, and he was repeating the same process. And the other man was down there with the stuff holding and receiving the whole hair coming from their hoocha hoocha down there. I was just thinking, and you can hear him, he's doing it, he's multitasking, you know, that's what I call it, he's multitasking, because he's doing the shaving, and then at the same time, he's talking to the members, because you can hear them saying, amen, and they were speaking the language, so if you're not someone that understands this language, you will not bother, but you will hear them say amen, and he was talking and preaching and preaching and shaving and preaching, and only God knows what he was talking about. I do not know, because I do not understand the language either. Okay, but I can hear them say amen. And I just wonder, don't people think? Because there's something, if you're not an African, comment below and let me know if you've heard of the stories or not. But I'm going to tell you now, there's something that is common in Africa. Because in Africa, we believe so much in this voodoo, witchcraft, and all these other supernatural powers out there, you know. So, from when you're a child, from when you're very young, you're being taught to be careful with your clothing, your hair. I think they start from your hair, like when you go to the hair studios to make your hair, you know. Your mom will always tell you, make sure you come back with all the hair that they comb out from your hair, you know, all the hair that falls out from your head, gather all of them together and bring them back home. When the boys go out to the barbing shop to get their hair cut, same thing has been told to them. When you go there, make sure you separate your own hair from other people's hair and then bring your hair back home, you know. I know that my mom will always say, when you get there, clean the, you can help them to sweep the area if there are hairs before they start making your own hair, you know, from other clients, you know, during the day. And clean everywhere so you know all the hair around that area at the moment is yours, so you can gather all of them and bring them back home. So this is something that most of us do. People don't just throw. And for the older ladies that they've started seeing their period, you know, this menstrual cycle and all that, you always advise not to throw away your pad just like that. You have to package it properly and you have to be careful where you drop it. If you go out, you're not at home, you're far away from home, you have to package it very well. And if you cannot find somewhere that you know you can put it away and no one can get it, then tie it very well and take it along with you till you get home, and then you dispose it where you're sure that no one can take it to do anything crazy. And the same goes with your old undies. You just don't throw them away. When you have old undies, you put all of them together, your inner wears when they're old, you gather all of them together and pour some kerosene or some, you know, lightning fluid, and set it ablaze. You burn them, gather the ashes and throw it away. You just don't leave your things out there. You know, even when you wash your clothes, you're advised not to leave the clothes outside overnight because you don't know the spirits and all of that. Some people don't really feel like, what kind of story is this? But I'm just telling you. So when I saw this video, I could not understand how these ladies could stand there and allow this stranger to do that to them. Like, this is your body, this is your private part. Why would you allow a stranger to take care of it for you? Do you know what he wants to do with the hairs that he's collecting? Because he collected all the hairs from all the ladies that he shaved. He just didn't leave it for them to gather it themselves. He collected it. So what is he going to do with this? That is the big question that people are not asking. But anyway, let me know in the comment section what you think. Leave me a comment below, let us discuss, let's analyze this topic. Tell me what you think about this, and I'll insert the clip for you to watch yourself. For now, I'm out.
Wow, ba, you're ready. Send your way to your piano. Wow, ba, one out there, roll pants. Men perceive a pop one thing, then go for a cassette. What's off one in the road where your pants? Men penis, ah. What's your say? It's why I want to ba, oh, roll pants, no, so for any, may you what I asked your mom. Hallelujah, pa.
Amen.
It is said you are not making Leviticus and some said you are kind. What's the other? What's the other? Why are they winning with me? No one married. That's after we said the direction we said, he said, you wouldn't mean in every year. Me as of opening me could gather. Now, what's it?
Amen.
What's your fear? Sign your mom, we say, so for me, now, honest, I mean, yes, that direction we are. And what for say, and one friend, I make.